Welcome back, everyone. We're going to be tearing into the box sent over by Round 2 Models, MPC's 125th scale 1982 Dodge van in the Turtle Wax sponsorship. I think it's really awesome that Round 2 is throwing some money at getting some new licenses instead of the same old thing. They're giving us something from Turtle Wax that looks awesome. Love all the new style decals, ideas on this thing. It is a 2-in-1. You can build it a full custom, and I mean full custom, cruising van, or you could build a stock work van. So let's take a look at everything inside the box when you get yours. We've got a set of nice tires here. These are Goodyear branded tires. Nice tread design. Black wall all the way around, no pad printing on these ones. You get four of those for a stock, no extra tires on that one. You get two steel axles to support the weight of the kit. You get a beautiful set of turbine wheels. Love the look of those. Definite custom style wheels. We get another chrome tree with some lake pipes. Excellent work truck style mirrors. We've got all kinds of interior accessories. We've got a stock set of hubcaps here. We got the bumpers, front and rear, with the nice grille and the emblems on that. The headlights are molded in on this one. We've got all kinds of glass. We've got a clear moonroof if you want to install it. For a better view, we've got a smoked moonroof. We've got, thankfully, red tinted lenses for the back. We've got a double set of glass for the vehicle, clear windshield and back windows. We've got tinted back glass, windshield. That's awesome. I love that smoke look. Very appropriate for any style van. A gorgeous set of new decals on this one. Turtle Wax logos, just a man. Look at these awesome, like, turtle shell for going along the side of the van. Even on a work van, that would be appropriate as they decorated it for their company. Check out all the little logos for other vehicles. Turtle Power. That's adorable. All kinds of ideas. Look at this little guy right there. Somehow, he's got to be incorporated into the build. Regular old-style Turtle Wax emblems. Modern emblems. Really a nice decal sheet. We got license plates, 82 plates, Illinois plates, windshield banners, two windshield banners. There are a lot of ways you can go with that. Nice work, Round 2, on that improved decal sheet. Let's take a look at the styrene on the other side. We've got some dress-up interior panels for that custom van. We've got wheel backs and short exhaust dumps for those lake pipes if you use that option on yours. We've got a full interior set. That's actually the top to a table. Some beautiful curtains across the back window so you can close them off so Dad doesn't see what you're doing. Nice interior pieces. We've got seat mounts. Engine halves. Yes, this is a van, but you will have a full engine in it if you want to cut the hood open. Cylinder heads, looks like more frame parts here. Optional fog lights, I'm guessing. Manifold, speaking of manifolds, be very careful. One was bouncing around loose in my bag, so don't lose that, you'll pull your hair out. We've got a stock exhaust system, giant drive shaft, differential and leaf springs. We got a radiator. We got a nice stock Dodge steering wheel, air cleaner, oil pan, intake. All nice detail on those parts. This is your stock exhaust coming back to the muffler. On this one, we've got a lower air dam. We've got a spoiler option. You can see that in better detail. On the top of the box, you can put that giant whale tail up there. Don't forget that when you go through McDonald's. We got the dashboard. Mine's loose in the box. Nice looking. Didn't see any decals for the dashboard. Would like to remind Round 2 and other companies, we love dash decals. One of our favorite things, makes our life easier. Nice set of bucket seats here. Two-parters. We got some big old bench seats for the back. Got to put little hinges on those, lay those down flat, all pudding. Got a master cylinder, looks like. Looks like a master cylinder for the brakes. Could be wrong. We got that big slogan, Dodge Van Extended. Look at the interior. Quilted interior. Get a good view of it back there. If you do it as a work van, just ignore all that. Just a fancy work van. Got our doghouse molded in. Looks nice. Underbody's got the appropriate ribbing. Got our frame here. Fuel tank. Side rails. Even got a little brake line detail molded in. Got our cross members. Mounting our big old, what is that, a 360? I guess a 360 in a big work van. Instead of a 318. A lot of them came with 318s, I bet. Nice molding on that body. Roof ribs are appropriate. Side rails, opening doors. Nice trim work. Got the hinges on there and everything. Got the Dodge logos. Got our back end. Nice large buckets. Fill those with silver paint and then put your taillights in there. Nice looking. Got our little fuel cap on the side. So I'm not even sure which way I'm going to take it. I know it's not going to be a full custom. Here's what it could look like as a work van. But I'm thinking green roof and the giant green turtle wax decal down the side for a work van. I think that would look cool with the turtle wax emblems or the older turtle wax. There's a lot of ways we can take this. So I'm going to get to work on mine and be right back. After a super short build period, which is just fine for me, I want to get the painting and detailing this thing because I got an idea for it. I'm going to combine elements of the all the way custom and the stock work van to do like a custom work van like you see in shops, so we'll interweave them like Pauly Shore would say, and I'll be building my version of this kit. So something I noticed under the body I didn't show, if you want to add all that glass to the roof or all the other stuff, they have nicely molded in large grooves that can't be seen from the top, but they molded them in. And if you just take your hobby knife and cut around, you could do that clear roof to view inside the interior. You could do the moonroof. You could just do the vent on the back. Whatever you wanted to do to make it look awesome. And it's got a nice molded texture inside too. So you could paint that up like it's carpeted shag on the roof and all that. There's quite a bit. But what I want to do is just a mild custom van that still delivers turtle wax every day, and build it up as such. So we've got the frame glued together. This cross piece goes in. Make sure that little hole is on that side and then it arcs that way because our exhaust is going to line up with that when we do factory exhaust, those two holes. The differential does not sit very far down, but that's how it looks when it's glued in, and I push the metal axle through just to make sure I can still get it through. Before I paint, I'll pull it back out. The other steel axle goes through the front. Those holes are gigantic. So you're not going to have to worry about it fitting through those whatsoever when you build it up. The engine, after we paint it and glue it into the chassis, is pretty much going to be the last time we see it unless we flip the vehicle over. So get a good look at our small block. I'm going to call it a 360. Nice looking engine. I put all the chrome parts on it because I'm going to be painting it up like a stock working engine. Got our manifolds on it. I'll detail it since it's here and since you'll want to see that. And then that's just going to glue into the frame. The drive shaft's going to attach to it, and unless you decide to cut the hood open and build some mounts for it to hang from, that's going to be the last time we see that engine. Got our exhaust system, drive shaft, air cleaner all ready to go. We'll get this all painted and metallicized. Wheel backs, I am pretty sure I'm going to go with the turbine wheels. Custom van, but I love that they're molded open and they've done such a nice job on those that I really want to use them. The hubcaps, of course, look nice, but I think I'm going to want to use those custom wheels on my van. This little piece here that we showed off, the other was the lower air dam for the front bumper if you chose to use it. This is actually a trim piece, according to the instructions, that it will be body color that will go in between the grill and the bumper. So I made sure to salvage that. We'll get that painted up, be able to slide that in there. The dashboard was loose. I'll just have to stick it to my painting area, and then we'll get it all sprayed. Same as the steering wheel. Got the belt and pulley and fan system. I haven't attached the alternator yet. We'll leave that chrome. But I do want to paint that. I don't think the fan would be chrome on a stock engine. Now, I'm not doing a full custom interior, but I love these drapes. These are so cool. They're going to look so cool in the back. hanging across the window, like so. So yeah, I'm gonna be using those just because I want to. I'll paint those up a nice color. And the front bucket seats, we'll be painting those up as plain Jane work seats so that they can get all deliveries done. And that's pretty much it. We just gotta get all this stuff on the table, the interior. If you were gonna cut the hood open, you'd mount your master cylinder here and your heater box here. Those are the two parts that we saw earlier. That's where they would be glued on. I'm not opening any of that up, so I'm just leaving that off as it is. I'm gonna get all this stuff into paint and you can come watch that right now. Thank you. It doesn't take a ton of work to end up with a sharp looking van kit. So this is where we are right now. Very basic because I did the work vehicle look on it with just a little bit of custom. Like, you know, they still deliver stuff with it, but they want it to look flashy. That's what I like. I've got the body here sitting on top of the chassis. We'll pull those apart in a second. But you can see how doing the bottom and the white, like the body van color, look contrasts nicely with the black frame and everything on there. I like that look. The small block is in there. The factory exhaust, the stock exhaust instead of the lake pipes, mates right up with everything. We got our drive shaft, we got our alternator in, and we can pull this off. Check out that interior. Now, there were no dash decals. You saw how easily I made the dash stand out with that black base coat of primer. We got our nice grooves in the seat. We got our nice indentations in the dashboard and shadows and doghouse and everything. So dressed up the doghouse with a little bit of plastic chrome trim, the door panels. We are all set to go. And of course, you could put in that dividing wall with the curtains and the windows and pimp out the interior with the table and the benches and all that. Do what you want with it, however you want to decorate it. I wanted a delivery truck. Got the chassis all by itself, a little bit of dry brushing with the gray on the bottom. All set. Watch your wheel and tire set. They do friction fit and then push on to the wires through the centers of each axle, but they may end up a little bit crooked, so just watch yourselves when you line those up and bend them back into place if need be. The wheels look awesome. A little bit of black wash in there, a little bit of detail sanding that tire tread really brings it out. Check out the grill with that colored insert. Now, you could have went with white, gray, whatever you wanted to on there. I went with green since that's the color of the lower part of my body. But we got our reflectors and turn signals. We got our ornament there. We got our grill blacked out. Easy to work with, not a problem at all. All we got to attach now is the rear bumper and the mirrors. That's it. The rest of this stock material is left over. We got the body ready to go. I was a little too dark on those vents on the front being white, so I did tone it down with a little coat of white paint over the top so we can still see them, but they're not as prominent. Did the door handles, the mirrors, got the glass in, used the Mod Podge to hold it in, got the drapes in, used the tinted window in the back and the drapes. That looks awesome. Went and did the Dodge logo with a silver pen, completely forgetting that I'll be putting the decals right over the top of that, so it won't matter anyways. Got our tail lights in with Mod Podge as well. Still getting a kick out of those drapes, check that out, so people can't look in and see the cargo. Most of the screen's gonna get covered up, but I wanna make sure the bottom of the van was all set. Just gotta use my red marker to do those tail reflectors. The reflectors for the front are part of the grill. We'll be laying our big decals down. I'll be deciding what decal I want in the back and any decals that I want across the back of the van. And that is it. The grill should mount right across the front. I haven't even tried it yet. Yeah, see, look at that. Hold that in with a little friction before I glue it, and that green stripe looks nice across there. Matches the rest of the green, looks lovely. So that's what she's gonna look like with that nice front end. And we've got these awesome decals to stick on. They've even got openings for the fuel tank and the reflectors in the back, going around the rear tail lights, everything. There's even a little TV screen I didn't notice before. So we are all set up. I'm gonna get to working on mine and I'll be right back with the final. Here's the 82 Dodge van from MPC, sent over by Round 2 Models, available to you coming up pretty soon. I will link down in the description where you can get this bad boy on pre-order if it hasn't arrived by the time this video comes out. Check it out. I combined things from the custom van and the work van to make my own personal van. I got the tinted windows in the back with the curtains, but I did the work truck style interior. I used the custom wheels, but did the work truck style paint job, and then used the custom turtle decals, because that's pretty the coolest thing, and there's really not anything else you could use those decals on, because they were very nicely made for this van to fit around the taillight, the fenders, underneath the trim work, and everything. Then painted the green underneath it, which blends in nicely. Got the bright red roof. I applied 3 coats of future floor polish. I wanted it super shiny because it's a turtle wax van. Say that in Sammy Davis Jr.'s voice. It's the turtle wax van. Okay, anyways, so that'll get stuck in your head for a week or two. But then I used the older style decals, put them on the back, used the modern banner on the front and the more modern name across the back of there. I just made it my own kit. The mirrors went on with super glue. They went on real easy. Nice work style mirrors. We got a sweet looking van. It's got enough detail to satisfy. You're never going to see that small block again unless you cut open the hood. So if you just want to build like a curbside and skip anything and just put the exhaust on so you can see the little bit of the exhaust sticking out the back, that's fine too. Remember, it's your kit, so you build what you want to see. You want the big whale tail, you want the more modern turtle wax emblem, you want the turtle decals, you want a metallic green underneath them, whatever you want. Have fun building up your kit your way. I really like this. I think it's a cool thing. Now, what I'm going to do, I rarely build the same kit twice in 1 year. I'm going to request a second Dodge van kit when they're out. Maybe from Round 2, I'll email them, or maybe from another sponsor out there like Model Roundup, because there is a particular longer wheelbase Dodge van that I absolutely love from a very fun TV show from Canada that I want to replicate on the show. And I'm going to ask for it. If they send it over, we're going to get to see that van. Now, if you guess what it is, throw it in the comments section. And if not, you'll get to see the episode when it eventually airs. Even if I have to buy one myself, I gotta build it up. Very easy to build this kit, no problems whatsoever. You get 2 wheel options, you get pretty much a 2-in-1 kit with a ton of super nice turtle wax decals left over, including these awesome colored turtle power ones. We go on a dragster. We got that little TV screen. We got some other of the older style turtle wax logos, little dude on there. You got plenty of options. So I do recommend you get this one. This Dodge van doesn't come out very often. Can't wait to see what other variations. We know that Round 2 will throw in there for decals and ideas with it. Looking forward to it. Maybe a Coke version with like an entire assortment of all their different Coke machines in it. Who knows? That'd be a cool thing to see. That's just my suggestion. I know they watch the videos. So as always, thanks for watching the show. Remember, it's just a hobby. Have fun. Take a breath. Don't get upset. And always build for you. I will see all of you at the next episode.